नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम टू फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑफ सर्कल. दिस इज राजेश. इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी रिमेनिंग प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 10.2. लेट अस सी क्वेश्चन 12. अ ट्रायंगल एबीसी इज ड्रॉन टू सर्कमस्क्राइब अ सर्कल ऑफ रेडियस 4 सेंटीमीटर सच दैट सेगमेंट बीडी एंड डीसी इनटू व्हिच बीसी इज डिवाइडेड बाय द पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्ट डी are of length 8 cm and 6 cm respectively. Find the side AB and AC. So in this problem, we have given length of OD, that is radius, which is 4 cm. We have given the length of BD, which is 8 cm and CD 6 cm. What we have to find? We have to find this length AC and AB, right? Now, CD is 6, so CE will also be 6 because they are tangent length. BD is 8, so BF is also 8. Now for this length AC, I know this CE, so we have to find AE. Now AE and AF, they are equal, so I will consider them as X. Now I have an unknown quantity X that I have to find out. AE and AF, their value is X. So for that I am going to use the property of area of triangle. How? So for that I will divide this triangle in three triangles by joining OA, OB and OC. Now area of the three triangles can be find out by using formula half into base into height. Like for BOC we have base BC and height OD. Similarly for triangle AOC we have base AC and height OE, because if I join this OE, it will be perpendicular to this side AC. The sum of all these three small triangles will give me area of this bigger triangle, and that I will get in terms of X, as the value of AE is unknown. Now I will also find the area of this triangle using the Heron's formula, which you have studied in your 9th standard. Now I have two different sets of answers for area of triangle. I will equate them, and as there is only one unknown X, I will find that unknown X. Now I will put that value of X and find the value of AB and AC, right? Let us see. We have given a circle with center O and triangle ABC circumscribes the circle. OD is given 4, BD is given 8 and CD is given 6 cm. We have to find the value of AB and AC. In construction we join OA, join OB and OC. Now AC and AB, they touch circle at point E and F. Since the length of tangent drawn from an external point are equal, we will say that CD is equals to CE is equals to 6, BD is equals to BF is equals to 8, and AE is equals to AF is equals to X. Now AB, value of AB is equals to AF plus BF, that gives me X plus 8. Similarly AC is AE plus CE, that gives me X plus C, and BC will give me BD plus CD, that is 8 plus 6 is equals to 14. Now I will find a semi-perimeter. Semi-perimeter is sum of three sides divided by 2, half of perimeter. So let us put respective values. I get value of S as X plus 14. Now by using Heron's formula, area of triangle is square root of S into S minus BC into S minus AC into S minus AB. So all three sides one by one I will subtract from semi perimeter. Now I will put the value of BC, AC and AB and simplify. After simplification I get the value of triangle ABC as square root of X plus 14 into X into 8 into 6. So this is one answer for area of triangle ABC. Now I will also say that area of triangle ABC is half of triangle OBC plus half of triangle OAB plus half of area of triangle OAC. Now I will put the formula, that is half into base into height, that is half into BC into OD plus half into AB into OF plus half into AC into OA. Now we have values for BC, AB, AC, OD, OF and OE. Now OD, OE and OF, they are radius, so their values is 4. Let us put their respective values. Simplify it. On simplification, we get answer as 4x plus 56. Now equation 1 and equation 2, both are the values for area of triangle ABC. So let us equate them. Now as on left hand side we have square root. So what I will do, I will square on both the sides and simplify this equation. So squaring on both the sides and simplifying, I will get a quadratic equation as x square plus 7x minus 98 is equals to 0. Now this is a quadratic equation. I have to solve this quadratic equation. We have different methods. Let us use factorization method. For that, I will first find prime factors of 98. So prime factors of 98 are 2, 7 and 7. Now I arrange 98 into factors such that their addition is 7 and their product is minus 98. So that is 14 and minus 7. So I will write this equation as x square plus 14x minus 7x minus 98 equal to 0. From first two terms I will take x common, and from rest two terms I will take minus 7 common. That gives me x plus 14 into x minus 7 is equals to 0. So I have either x plus 14 0 or x minus 7 0. So this gives me value of x plus 14 as 0 or x minus 7 as 0. Hence I have x is minus 14 or 7, but the value of x cannot be negative, therefore the value of x is 7. Now I got the value of x. So AB is equals to AF plus FB. That gives me x plus 8, that is 7 plus 8 is equals to 15. And the value of AC is AE plus EC. That gives me x plus 6 is equals to 6 plus 7, that is 13 centimeter. So I have value of AB as 15 centimeter and value of AC as 13 centimeter. So hence we got the value of AB and AC. Let us move to our last question. Prove that opposite sides of quadrilateral circumscribing a circle subtend supplementary angle at the center of circle. Now what it means? It means that angle AOB plus angle COD, their addition is 180 degree. Similarly, angle BOC plus angle AOD is 180 degree. So first we write given. Let ABCD be the quadrilateral circumscribing the circle with center O. ABCD touches the circle at point PQRS. We have to prove that angle AOB plus angle COD is 180 degree and angle AOD plus angle BOC is 180 degree. We will do a small construction. We will join OP, OQ, OR and OS. Now let us rename these angles which we got at the center as shown in the figure. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, we have renamed them. Now in triangle AOP, in triangle AOP and triangle AOS, I will first prove them congruent, and hence I prove that this angle 1 and 8, they are equal. So we have already done how to prove that angle AOP is congruent to angle AOS. Angle APO, we can see here angle APO is equal to angle ASO, each is 90 degree as radius is perpendicular to tangent. OA is their common hypotenuse, and OP and OS, they are radii of the circle, therefore they are equal, and hence the triangle AOP is congruent to triangle AOS. As these two triangles are congruent, I will say that angle AOP is equal to angle AOS by CPCT, that is angle 1 is equal to angle 8. Similarly, we can prove that angle 2 is equal to angle 3, angle 4 is equal to angle 5 and angle 6 is equal to angle 7. Now I will add all the angles, and sum of all the angles will be equal to 360. As we can see here, they are the angles at point O. Now we know that angle 1 plus angle 8 is they are equal, so in place of angle 8 I can replace angle 1. Similarly, in place of angle 3 I can replace angle 2. So let us do that. So I have angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 2 plus angle 5 plus 5 plus 6 plus 6 plus angle 1. How I am arranging them? I am arranging them in order that I will prove that angle AOB and angle COD, their addition is 180 degree. So I want this angle AOB and COD first. So I want angle 1, 2, 5 and 6. So as 5 and 4 are equal, so in place of 4, I am replacing 5. And not in place of 5, I replace 4, right? So I have each angle 2 times. So I will say that 2 times of 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 6 is 360 degree. Now angle 1 plus 2 gives me angle AOB, and angle 5 plus 6 gives me angle COD. So therefore I will say that angle AOB plus angle COD is 180 degree. Similarly, we can prove that angle BOC plus angle AOD is also equals to 180 degree. Right? So this is how we solve all the problems of exercise 10.2. Thank you.